everyone, I'm back. Let me give you a little update of what happened last time I was at Palmer. By the way, we're heading back to Palmer today. So when I was there last time, I had a mild failure, so to speak. Basically, it looked like I got a massive exhaust leak somewhere in the exhaust system right at the last session when I was there. So I got home, put the car on a quick jack real quick the next day, and took off the belly pan. And what I found is, on the initial headers, what I found is one of the O2 sensor bungs, basically the welds fell all around it. That's right, the welds fell all around it, and the whole bung fell out, creating a about inch and a half in diameter hole in my short header, which translated into this massive exhaust leak. I quickly ordered brand new O2 sensor bungs and had them weld in. I replaced both of them. Let me tell you why. Header I got on this car, I got maybe like 8-9 years ago, and this is your eBay special or Chinese made header, and it's not the top quality, but hey, it works. It worked for me for the last 8-9 years, so I still have it on my car. But anyhow, I mean, how these headers are made is basically the whole header is made out of stainless steel. Now, what they cut corners is they use mild steel for the O2 sensor bungs, and with that, with the bungs being mild steel, it rusts over time. And basically, this is what happened in this situation. The bung basically rust, the weld rusted all around and basically fell out. So creating the massive exhaust leak, I fixed it and basically put it back on the car. And as you hear, I don't have a massive exhaust leak, and it worked out pretty good. But with that being said, it's probably a good time to look into something more of a quality, maybe Italian nature, like a Super Sprint, which sounds very appealing, because I have cams, airbox, and I have a lot more air coming into the engine than was stacked. So the oversized V1, I believe they're called, headers in section 1, would probably benefit a lot in this situation. But they're kind of pricey, so I'm still on the fence about that. At the same time, I did the pre-check inspection, make sure everything is intact. As you guys know, I had quite an adventure with this car last year. I checked the airbox, make sure everything is okay, and everything is fine. So we're looking good there. Now today I'm gonna be focused on getting some actual data in and getting some baseline numbers. For whatever reason, every time I go to Palmer, the GPS signal is always weak there for me, and my apps on my phone don't seem to work good catching actual lap time. So I'm gonna try to see if I can get some base numbers today and get some actual data to see what where I stand and how everything is progressing. But last time was pretty good, so I was happy to get so to speak, few shakedown sessions. Now let's dial everything in terms of kinematics of the car. So I'll see you guys there.
All right, we're at Palmer, ready to head out for the first session. Done with the driver's meeting, so let's see what the day brings. Here's a view of the paddock. A lot of cool cars today. New E46 M3s as well.
Do you mind giving someone a ride along?
Nah, no problem.
Moses.
No problem, Radek.
I get my head. Oh, ouch.
How you doing today?
Good, thanks, man.
Ready?
Thank you.
once. Actually, this time the GPS kind of worked the whole time, so I got some data in the book. The whole day on and off, it was working and it wasn't, so I really don't know what was the quickest time of the day. So, but this session felt really good.
All right, made it successfully through the whole day. Man, today was really awesome. Got some really good pace and set some really good laps. Unfortunately, my GPS again was acting up. I'm not sure what's going on. Like, there was some session I really couldn't get it to work, and I don't really know the official times I was making. The times, the session that was working, it looked like I had a best one. I think was a 152, if I recall, which is not too terrible. But on some good notes, I want to mention the Federals FZ201s are wearing very nicely. This is what they look like after 17 sessions altogether. So they're wearing pretty evenly. I did some temperature readings today as well, and looks like from this edge to this edge, it's about 12 degree difference after a session. They seem to like 32 hot PSI, and they last a whole session as well. They don't really grease up. Maybe a little if you overdrive them, but they're looking good. So yeah, one thing I want to do mention is for all you guys out there running CSL airboxes, see these bolts right here. Make sure you use blue Loctite on them, because I had them tightened very snugly and somehow they managed to undo themselves and vibrate off. I mean, I lost three bolts, only was left one. Thank God I had something similar in my toolbox that I could basically substitute in the meantime. I have some spare ones at home. So yeah, if you have a CSL airbox, make sure you use a blue thread rocker on there, because there's a good chance if you're driving in a place like this, such as Palmer Motorsport Park or any place else, there's a good chance they will vibrate right off. I mean, I did put thread rocker on, and they seem to be not moving. So yeah, that's just a pointer. Hope you guys enjoyed today's video, and looking forward to the next track day, which is probably in the next few days. Looks like to be Club Motorsports, one of my favorite places. So don't forget to subscribe to the channel, and hit a like, and I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.